हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू हियर नाउ?
सर
आदि केशवा, कैन यू हियर?
यस सर
ओके, नाउ यू कैन सी द पीपीटी पा
सर
यू कैन सी पीपीटी
सर
ओके, थैंक यू पा, थैंक यू. ओके, इन लास्ट क्लास we discuss syllabus of building materials and construction and what are the textbook we have to refer. Those details we discussed in the last class. As we know, building material, the basic building materials are stone, brick, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, steel, etc. These are all building materials. We already discussed in the last class there is the difference between fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. What are the materials are passing 4.75 mm sample, we call it as in a fine aggregate. And what are the materials are retained 4.75, we call it as in a coarse aggregate. In last class we discussed these things. Stone as in a building material, as we know, stone is the basic building material. Stone as in a basic building material, one of the major material. As we know, this is in a solid form, non-metallic mineral. In another word, we call it as in a rock, in that larger piece. Means based on the size, in a larger material, we call it as in a rock, and small pieces, we call it as in a stone. Okay. The key difference between the rock and stone, which is the rocks can be both soft and hard, and stone can only be hard. There are the different types of rocks out there, limestone rock and sandy rock. Like these types of rocks are there. These are a good example for we can expect the rock in both the way, there is the hard as well as the soft. And stone only we can expect in a hard form, like a granite, marble. These are all example. And stone materials are often used for the construction because they are strong and durable and resistant to the weather condition. Means we can expect there is the material should be strong, there is the building material should be strong, because what are the upcoming loads are there, it should resist the upcoming load. At the same time, durability, not only for 3 year, 4 year, 5 year, the durability should be more. Okay, and it should resist the all kind of weathering condition, whether that is the rainy season, summer season, or different climatic condition, it should resist. Okay. Usually stone should satisfy all these conditions, then only we call it as in a good stone or good stone material for the building construction. And stone is extracted from the natural deposit, we call it as in a quarry. Means where we can expect the stones, that site or that deposition, natural deposition site, we call it as in a quarry. In examination you can expect 1 or 2 marks define quarry, where the stone is extracted from the natural deposit, we call it as in a quarrying. And some of the competitive exams, we can expect this question, where stone is extracted, quarrying, mill, pick, like that. That is the quarrying is the correct answer. And next one is the classification of the rock. We classified into 3 types. There is the geological, mechanical, and physical classification. As per our syllabus, there is the geological classification. Under geological classification, igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock we can expect. Igneous rocks are formed from the solidification of molten rock material. Means where the igneous rocks are formed, the solidification means after it's come out from the lava or right, it become the solid, then that material we call it as an igneous rock. The best example is granite. And sedimentary rock, in last class we already discussed, due to wind, water, and so many sources, materials is moving from the or migrating from the one place to another place, and it is deposited in a one area. We call it as those kinds of material or rock, we call it as a sedimentary rock. Okay, sediment carried in rivers and deposited in clay, ocean, those kinds of material we call it as a sedimentary rock. And metamorphic rocks are rocks that have become changed by intense heat or pressure while forming. In the very hot and pressure condition, deep inside the earth crust, both the sediment and igneous rocks can be changed into metamorphic rock. Means due to high temperature, high pressure, that is the heat, okay, that is the deep inside to the earth crust, it is moon from earth crust, and both sedimentary and igneous, we can change it as a metamorphic rock. Okay, and these are all examples of igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic rock. Igneous rock, the best example is granite, marble, and metamorphic rock, that is the, yeah, in a simple term, that is the combination of sediment and igneous rock, like halite, okay, and sedimentary rock, that is the limestone, sandstone. These are all example of sedimentary rocks. And one more question is, come to the building materials in a stone, the common question is, what are the requirement of good building stones? It should reach some of the requirement, it should satisfy some of the requirement. What are those requirement? Simply, we can't select the, that is the stone available in the roadside or anywhere. It should satisfy some of the requirement. What are those requirement? First one is the crushing strength. Means the stone, usually we are using the stone as in a foundation material. It should carry the maximum load, means upcoming load. It should carry the maximum load, is it act as in a crushing, okay. It should satisfy requirement, should be the good structural stone. The crushing strength should be greater than 100 newton per mm square. Then it is called it as in a good building material or good building stone. Sometimes some of the stones, for example, sand and lime, it comes 50, 60 newton per mm square. Then we can't use it, those kinds of material or those kinds of stone for the foundation work. Okay, it should be greater than 100 newton per mm square, means it's good. It can take good, that is the crushing value. And next one is the appearance, means it's nothing but the outlook. The face work, it should have the fine, compact texture. Light color stone is preferred as dark color, are likely to fade out due to course of time. And the appearance, come to the appearance part, it has the fine compacted, means some of the stone we can see there is any voids and a grooves, and there is any cracks in the structure, and it should not there in a compacted texture manner. Okay, usually they like light color stones compared to the dark color stones, okay, for the appearance purpose. And next one is the structure. We already discussed, that is the texture should be uniform structure, okay. And it's free from cavities or cracks or holes or voids, okay. And patches of loose or soft material. Stratification should not be visible and naked eye. Means some of the things, for example, voids and grooves and cracks, with the help of naked eye, it should be aware. So that was it come to the good foundation stone. And come to the strength. A stone should be strong and durable to withstand the disintegrating the action of weather. Compression strength of building stone in a practice range between 60 to 200 newton per mm square. The strength of the stone, compression strength of the stone, it varies from 60 to 200 newton per mm square. Then it is called as a good stone. Sometimes 10, 5, or sometimes 30, 40, it make it as in it's not taking heavy strength, okay. And next come to the weight. It is an indication of porosity and density. If porosity is more or density is less, so we can't expect the weighted, that is the stone. Nowadays we can see there is a lightweight brick, okay, lightweight stones. Okay, these are all, we can't expect the, that is the porosity and density. For the stability of the structure or dam, retaining wall, self load should be there. That is nothing but a dead load, okay. Dead load should be there, otherwise it moves from the one point to another point easily, okay. Heavier stones are required where the arches, walls, domes, etc. Light stones may be chosen for the construction of arches, domes and walls or interiors. Usually they go for the lightweight stones. Next one is hardness. The property is important for the floors, pavement, apron of bridges, etc. The hardness is determined by the Mohr scale. Means Mohr scale is the one of the equipment or instrument With help of this one, we can calculate the hardness of stone. Okay, in a PGCET and GATE examination, you can expect this question. What are these? Which is the scale to find out the hardness of stone? Okay, Mohr scale is the one of the equipment or instrument used for find out the hardness. And toughness, the measure of impact the stone can withstand is defined as a toughness. The stone used should be tough when vibrator or moving loads as anticipated. For example, the toughness should be withstand the as a toughness impact. For example, that is the aircraft is landing on a runway. Okay, sudden impact we can expect in the runway. What are the materials we are used in the runway? It should have good toughness or impact. Then it can withstand the upcoming load. Or sometimes, especially in a road construction or highway construction, we can expect the vibrators or moving loads from the one point to another point. It should be anticipate the loads. Okay. Next one is porosity and observation. Porosity is depends on the mineral content, cooling time, and structural forming. Means that is the mineral composition. We already discussed it should be uniform texture, homogeneous. Okay. When there's an homogeneous and uniform structure, we can't expect the porosity. When homogeneous, it is too less, and there is a structural formation and the cooling time, especially in igneous rock. Okay. We can expect the porosity. And weathering, the resistance of stone against the wear and tear due to natural agencies should be high. Means the resistance of stones against the wear and tear due to natural agencies like acid rains and what are the polluted air coming from industries. Okay, these are all good example of natural agencies should be high. And workability, stone should be workable so that cutting, dressing, and bring it out in the required shape and size may not be uneconomical. Means workability, if you choose in the in a irregular manner, okay, it is completely effect on economy. It should be in proper shape. Otherwise, it causes a uneconomical structure. Fire resistant. Stone should be free from calcium carbonate, oxides of iron, and minerals having different coefficient of thermal expansion. It should have good fireproof resistance. Specific gravity. The specific gravity of the most of the stones lies 2.3 to 2.5. And some of the stones are 1.1, 1.2. Means it's again it is affected on density and weight and voids. Okay, the specific gravity should vary. Usually it varies 2.5 to 2.3 to 2.5. And what is the meaning of dressing of stones? Means we are giving the proper shape to the stone or material. We call it as a dressing of stone. In excavation time, in quarrying, okay, we expected in irregular shape. We can't use those kinds of material for the construction purpose. We have to give proper shape. Okay. That process is called as a dressing of stone. What is the purpose? Why it is required? To get a desired appearance, yes, in a rectangle shape or a square rectangle shape, square shape, it is a desired in appearance. Otherwise, if you use the random, that is the irregular shape, it's not good. It not create a good appearance. And to make the transport from quarrying easy and economical. Yes, if it is in a proper shape, we can accommodate a little bit more number of, that is the stones. Okay, it is not a proper shape in an it again it is reflected on economy at the same time transportation. It should the requirement of good masonry. Yes, if for the good masonry structure, for the stone masonry structure, rectangle shape and square shape is required. Okay, and to take the advantage of local people who are trained to such type of work. If it is in a proper shape, not skilled labors are required. Okay, with the available, there is the local peoples, we can train those peoples and we can make it as any classification. Quarry dressing and site dressing, there are the two types of there is the dressings are there. In quarry itself, that is the where it is available. Okay, there itself there is an dressing is one, and another one is site where we have to construct the building or any civil engineering structure. there also we can go for the dressing purpose. These are the some of the, there is the dressing pattern.
हेलो सर, सर योर वॉइस इज म्यूटेड सर।
ओके सॉरी सर सॉरी। And next one is the deterioration of stone work. What is the meaning of deterioration? Means when a stone, there is the stone is exposed to the out of field, okay, like a climate or wind or rain, temperature, living organism, etc. When it is exposed to the outside the world, okay, it loses its strength and property. We call it as an deterioration of the stonework. How we can improve the deterioration of stonework? In next slide, we will discuss how we can improve. Now, what are the things are there to reduce the strength of property? That is a stone property. First one is the alternative wetness and drying. Yes, alternative, due to alternative wetness and drying, we can alternative wetness and drying. And next one is the frost, means that is some of the moisture content, it is accumulated the space, okay, we can expect the deterioration. And impurities in the atmosphere, what are the impurities are there? Can anyone tell me what are the impurities in atmosphere? Can anyone?
Nitrogen oxides.
Sorry?
Sir, sulfur dioxide.
Okay.
Oxides of nitrogen and sulfur, sir.
Okay, because of that is the industries, it is omitting the polluted air. Okay. When it is deposited on a stone masonry, we can't expect the that is the strength up. It loses its property. And living organisms and movement of chemicals and nature of mortar. Mortar is that is the combination of cement and fine aggregate. We call it as a mortar. Concrete means that is a cement, fine aggregate, and a coarse aggregate. We call it as a concrete. During the construction time, we are using the mortar. That is the nature of the mortar also act an important role. Okay. When it is in a salt content, we expected when rich in salt content, we can't expect the, that is a good property in the stone. It loses its property. That is the one of the example. And rainwater, that is like acid rain, okay, rainwater. And temperature variation, sudden temperature is increases, suddenly temperature is decreases. Due to temperature variation also, we can't expect the good strength property of the stone. And vegetable growth, and some of the, that is the plants or some of the plantaries or growth in between these stones, okay. And wind, I already mentioned, there is a wind pressure that is also affected on deterioration of stonework. And rain, we already discussed, there is the rain act as in a both chemical and physical properties of stone. and the physical action is due to the erosion and transportation powers, and later due to the decomposition, oxidation and hydration of the mineral present in the stone. Means when the rainwater act as an act both the physical and the chemical property, or it loses both physical and chemical properties of stone. As a physical action due to, we already discussed, there is a transportation of powers, means erosion, and small that is the parts are, it eroded. That is created the physical property of the stone, and chemically it loses its property due to hydration, oxidation, it loses its property. And the physical action, alternative wetting and drying, we already discussed, there is the same causes, the internal stresses, alternative wetting and drying, sudden temperature is increases, suddenly it decreases, alternative. Okay, and consequently disintegration. Chemical action in the industrial area, the acid rains water react with the constituents of stone, leading to its deterioration. Chemical agents like the smoke, fumes, acid and acid fumes present in the atmosphere, deterioration the stone containing the CaCO3 and MgCO3 are affected badly on the stone. We already discussed that is the deterioration of stonework. Rainwater acts as in a both physical and chemical stone, and physical action due to the erosion. We already discussed that the transportation powers later due to decomposition. And how to prevent preserve the stonework? We already discussed that is the what are the things or deter or reduce the strength of stonework. And reduce the strength of stonework. And now how we can prevent, prevention of stone is essential to prevent its decay. There are the different types of stone require different treatment. For example, granite having the different treatment work, and marble having the different, and sandstone, lime, there are the different treatment, is the methods are there. Coal tar is one of the material. When we apply the coal tar on the surface of the stone, okay, we can prevent the, that is the moisture content get into heat, and linseed oil, paint, paraffin, and solution of alum and the soap, and solution of barite, that is the BaOH2, and barium hydrate. These are the some of the materials we can prevent the stonework. And next one is, there is the bricks. Before going to bricks, in examination you can expect these kinds of questions with respect to stone. Okay, first one is, what are the requirements of good building stones? You can expect 3 to 4 marks. And next one is classification of rock, that is the geological classification, igneous rock, metamorphic rock, and sedimentary rock. Requirement of stone and define dressing, and what is the purpose of dressing, and what is the classification of dressing, quarrying site, and site dressing. And next one is the, what are the tools you are using for the dressing, and deterioration of stonework, and how you can preserve the stonework. These are the usual questions you can expect in examination for 5 to 6 marks with respect to stonework. Now we are moving to brick. As we know, there is the brick dimension is, there is the 9 by 9 by 19 centimeter without mortar. With mortar, 10 by 10 by 20 centimeter, that is the with mortar. Okay, brick may be made up of burnt clay or a mixture of sand and lime or Portland cement, concrete, clay. Means now bricks are different. Last 20-30 years, only bricks means we are assuming that is the red color what is there in the picture. Okay, now we can expect different kinds of bricks like lightweighted bricks, aerated bricks, lightweighted bricks, aerated bricks, and lightweight bricks, like these kinds of fly ash brick and black brick. We are using these kinds of bricks for the construction industry. Okay, and clay bricks are also commonly used since they are economical and easily available because it's completely manufactured with the help of the mud. Mud is basically it is available in a economical manner and easily available. And next one is the fog. Fog is nothing but here there is an impression on the brick. For example, A, B, C, or V, M, like the those kinds of that is the impression we can see on top surface of the brick. We call it as an a frog. Why it is required means it acts as in a key for in between the two brick. It acts as in a key. It holds some of the mortar and act as in a key in the lateral and the longitudinal direction. Okay. The usually the depth of the frog is 1 to 2 centimeter. Okay, this is also one of the questionary in your competitive and competitive examination. Usually they will ask what is the depth of frog, that is the 1 to 2 centimeter. This is a usual question in PGCET and some other civil services examination. Okay, and manufacture of clay brick. How we can manufacture the clay bricks? The preparation of earth, molding, drying, and burning brick. These are the procedure. Students, any doubts? Any doubts?
No, sir.
You're facing any doubts or you are understanding, students?
Understanding, sir.